Go ahead.
I'm Sarah Timmer, and I feel fortunate about being the bean.
I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Welcome back to Between Two Beans. We're here. It's season one, episode three. Today we're here with Sarah Timmer. So first, Sarah, tell us who you are and what you do here.
Ooh. Okay, well, Sarah Timmer, I'm the curriculum director for the district. So I get to visit all the schools in the district and help make sure that everyone's having the best education possible by giving teachers resources, helping where needed. Kind of got a lot of hats, so.
Would you say one, two, very nervous? That you're very nervous about being on this show?
I am very nervous about being on this show.
It's a lot of pressure.
It's
kind of a big deal.
You know, I've been watching the episodes. I'm a big fan.
Good.
We're on season three, and you asked me to be on there, so I felt very overrated to be on this episode with you.
That's really a good reference. That means you've really been watching. Okay, let's jump. We're going to jump right into it.
We better.
First, you brought me a coffee.
I did, yes.
Not a sponsor yet. Caribou Coffee, not a sponsor. But if you want to be a sponsor, you could. So if someone from Caribou Coffee were to see this, they could sponsor the show.
That'd be a great idea.
What's the best piece of wisdom you've ever received?
Oh, well, I can think of two pieces of wisdom. I know you told me to keep it under five, so I'll go quick. The first one is it's okay to make a mistake. I think sometimes even in school, life, you have to try new things. Like coming on here today, I might make a mistake when I'm talking, but it's better to try it out and learn from things than to not do it at all. And then the second one I learned from the movie Frozen.
Oh gosh.
Yeah, so this one's more recent. And so it's on Frozen 2. I know some of you middle school and high schoolers just watch Frozen 1 and maybe skip Frozen 2, but you can go ahead and watch it. She's kind of desperate. She loses her way. She's in this big cave and she feels like she can't go on. And then she starts singing and she has to take just the next step. So even when things are hard, she is singing to herself and she's saying, just take the next step. And so I know the elementary students know what I'm talking about. She didn't quit, she didn't roll over and say, I can't get out of this cave and Olaf is gone. Olaf like disappeared into thin air. It was difficult for her, but she kept on going. She took the next best step.
I would ask if Olaf is okay, but I feel like that's a spoiler, so I'm not gonna ask.
Yeah.
So
I can't tell you that.
So in the sequel, she didn't let it go. She took the next step.
She did, yes, yeah.
Interesting. Which one, if you had to power rank the Frozens,
which one is better? Frozen 2 is better than Frozen 1.
You heard it here. I don't know if we even need to continue. That's a bold statement.
You know, it is really a good message.
I hope you don't receive Frozen backlash from this.
Oh, I might, but I'm ready to battle it, defend it.
Okay. Excellent. So you go ahead and take one card out of here. It's double-sided, so you get two questions.
Oh, God. There you go.
If you found $100, what would you spend it on?
Coffee for teachers. That's what I'd spend it on.
$100 worth of coffee for teachers.
Yeah, it would get about 20 teachers coffee. Maybe a GBR.
That'd be a great choice. what are you most looking forward to in the next 10 years?
That is crazy.
That is a decade.
You know, I've learn to appreciate each decade, and so this next decade, I suppose I'm looking forward to watching my kids grow up and becoming little adults. I have a 9-year-old, a 7-year-old, a 5-year-old, and a 2-year-old, so I'm excited to see what the next 10 years brings.
Wow. Okay, as you alluded to earlier, we're to the part where you've already ruffled some feathers with your statements about Frozen.
Yes.
But now we're going to go to over, under, or properly rated.
This is my favorite part.
Okay.
Yes.
Great. So I've changed it a bit So you're allowed to say how you feel about it, and then one statement to back up your claim.
Okay.
And that's all you get.
One statement.
Yeah.
One sentence, three words.
A sentence is
okay.
Fine. Yeah.
Okay.
So underrated, overrated, or properly rated? The flu.
Overrated, because most people get healthy after the flu, and so I would consider the flu the stomach flu. So you get over it usually in 24 hours to 48 hours, and then you're good to go. So I think it's kind of overrated. You don't have to be scared of the flu so much.
But there's no debating that it's miserable.
It is, okay. But there's an end game.
Right, yeah? All right. Mm-hmm.
So if I had to pick an illness.
That'd be the one.
Yeah.
Because it's over quick.
Yeah.
All right. How about Transformers? And I don't mean like power. I mean like the car that turns into a robot or into a plane or whatever. So those kind of Transformers.
Underrated. Because I love the Transformer movies. And I also think the toys that change, I mean, you have two toys in one if you get a Transformer.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
So when you buy someone a Transformer, it's like buying two toys.
Yes.
I haven't ever thought of it that way. Would you say that they're more than meets? Would you say they're more than meets the eye?
Definitely.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then the last one.
Okay.
Over, under, properly rated. It's that time of year, as you can see from our beans up here. So, a winter storm watch, not a warning, just a winter storm watch. Over, under, properly rated.
Overrated. Overrated because it's not a warning. You know, I want to know that the storm is actually coming and that there's maybe a chance that we have a snow day. When it's just a watch, there's just too many questions. It'll probably
sure.
go away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because there's nothing worse than being promised and then having it pulled out from underneath you.
Yeah. I'd agree.
Shoot. Okay. So,
are we in a watch?
No.
Oh, okay.
Sorry to get your hopes
set. Shoot.
So, you said the flu is overrated.
Yes.
Transformers,
underrated.
Winter storm warning.
Overrated.
Okay. That's it. You did it.
Oh,
you did
all
it.
Right.
You did an awesome job.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks for coming on our little program. You did a great job keeping it, I think, at like the 5-minute mark. I don't know. It feels like it went by in a flash.
That's great.
Kind of like the first semester.
It really went by fast, didn't it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.